Ayan. Everybody was so...
Lig muna ako.
Everybody was so busy with other things before last year, ano? Kaya hindi kami nakasabay. But also at the same time, hindi pa kasi nalulunch yung pinagkakaguluhan natin ngayon. Okay? Yung Bitcoin Vault natin ngayon, no? So the Bitcoin Vault was launched only December, and then it started gaining its ground early this year, no? So that is what we will be talking about today. All right. So I did my due diligence with this company for 3 months. We were researching it. And we even went to Kazakhstan to do our due diligence. Tinignan po namin yung mga mining facilities nila doon. Tinignan namin yung kinausap namin yung mga CEOs, no? And we talked to everybody. We tried to see how serious they are in doing the business. And here we are today. All right. Today, we will be talking about Mining City and Bitcoin Vault. Mining City is the company. Bitcoin Vault is the cryptocurrency that we are talking about. Okay, I hope that you can see my screen. I will just turn on my monitor here. There you go. Okay, so Mining City and Bitcoin Vault is what we are going to talk about. Let's move on. What is Mining City? So Mining City is the most exciting place for cryptocurrency mining today, no? We are one of the top 10 mining companies in the world, no? And we were launched on January 7, 2019. And we are a global company present in Asia, Africa, and Latin America. So makikita niyo po, no? What you can see is we are present in the world. Makikita niyo po dyan, no? Hindi lang tayo online presence, but we are also physically present in these areas. People are moving, no? And not only the people that are moving, it's not only the people that are moving, but also andali lang, let's hold on. Okay. But also the CEOs and the officers of the company are moving in a great way and physically in these areas, Asia, Africa, Latin America. What I'm saying is they are engaged, no? So Mining City rents out the hash power to mine crypto. Mining City is the marketing arm, basically, no? We have 350,000 community today and we are rapidly growing. The last time I checked with our CEOs, we grow by about 10,000 members every day. Yan ang ating average growth. Mining City, the Mining City pool is also live in BTC.com and blockchain.com. Now, if you are into cryptocurrency, you would know, okay, that if you are in BTC.com and blockchain.com, that speaks a lot about your company. You know, it means that you are legitimate. But also, at the same time, it means that you are doing something right and good for the community and globally as well. So if you want to research Mining City, you will just check the website www.miningcity.com. Ngayon, ano naman yung Mindbest? Yung dalawa po na yan ay magkapatid na kumpanya. Because Mindbest basically produces our products, yung products natin. Mindbest is Technologically Advanced Infrastructure Company. Ito po ang isa sa pinaka-experts pagdating po sa mining ng cryptocurrency sa buong mundo. Okay? Yung CEO nitong Mindbest, nai-invite po yan sa lahat ng conventions as a speaker because he is not only an inventor, but he is also an innovator. Very, very innovative po. No? So this guy is a genius. No, they Mindbest has smart mining containers, and right now operational na ang 140 megawatts na mining facility ng Minebest. And 220 megawatts are under construction at this time. No, and remember, I told you earlier, I did my due diligence for 3 months. And going to Kazakhstan, that was the primary purpose that we went there to Kazakhstan to look at the mining facilities. You know, I remember there was one mining company in the Philippines, very, very strong. And then when the biglang nagsara, no? Nagsara sila kasi nung pinuntahan doon sa Europe yung kanilang mining facility. It was just a warehouse, a big warehouse, pero not even 1/8 of the warehouse was containing the mining facilities. Mamaya, I'll just show you a video of the mining facilities that we visited. When you see the videos, you will know what I'm talking about. The website of Minebest is www.minebest.com. Okay, if there's one thing that I share to everybody when I stand up and speak, no, I tell everybody who is listening to me that you do not take my word for it. Everything that I'm saying, don't take my word for it. What you should do, okay, after you listen and you like what I'm saying, you do your research. Kaya ito po yung mga website ng company natin. Okay, so again, I just would like to reiterate the strategic partnership of Minebest and Mining City. That's why they are very strong ngayon. They're both experts. Experts in cryptocurrency, Minebest yan. They build data centers tailored for providing professional hosting services of mining equipment for Mining City. And Mining City is the expert naman sa marketing. It rents out hash power and offer mining plans to its clients. They have their certificate of cooperation. So these are the CEOs. Mining City CEO is Gregorz Rogowski. He is Polish, from Poland po siya. And you can search him in Facebook, you can search him in Instagram, you can search him in LinkedIn, and they are also very, very active in Twitter. Ito naman si Minebest CEO, Eyal Abramovich. Si Eyal Abramovich naman is from Israel, no? And he owns 100% Minebest, no? This guy is the genius. Engineer yan, and it's really, really good. Amazing guy. You can research them. So, Mining City, the community is constantly growing. Right now, we are present in 3 areas. Okay, Asia, in Africa, and in Latin America. Very, very strong po tayo dyan, ano? And then, when I was checking around, I saw that we were already gaining ground also in Canada. In fact, when the people in Canada, yung marami pong nakikita ko mga speakers doon at nag-share, are also Filipinos. No? And if you can see in the banners here, it says Mining City Pool is live on BTC.com and blockchain.com. Mining City is a VIP customer of BTC.com. You can check that out as well. Punta lang po kayo sa BTC.com, punta kayo sa blockchain.com, and you will see that already. So these are pictures of the mining facilities of Minebest and Mining City. If you will see the machines on in your lower left, you will see the machines there, okay, and how evenly they are spaced, how they are doing that was during the construction. Okay, you will see the guard on the higher upper right, yung mga securities natin doon. We do not take security lightly. So our security guards are possessing high-powered weapons kasi ayaw natin na mailalagay sa alanganin ang negosyo natin, no? Okay, so the on the left is the 20 megawatts facility that I saw in Kazakhstan, and on my lower right is the 50 megawatts naman, no? If you will see the difference, tingnan niya lang yung mga yung kung kasi minsan sinasabi ng tao pareho lang naman ang picture yan, yung isa galing sa loob, isa galing sa labas. Hindi po. Look at the transformers in the middle of the 20 megawatts, yung upper right sa middle, di ba? Merong transformers. Dito po sa baba, kikita nyo walang transformers. So those are the pictures of our facilities. No, before I move on to Bitcoin Vault, I'd like to be able to establish for you yung sinasabi ko kanina. See, I'm just talking about it. I showed you pictures. That's very easy to do. But what we can do now, okay, what we can do now is, let's, okay, let me see. What we can do now is I'll show you, ano lang po ito, maikli lang po ito, no? So, tsagain nyo lang ng konti. This is, this will be very, very quick. Only 1 minute videos ang ipapakita ko po sa inyo. Number one, the megawatt, 20 megawatts mining facility in Kazakhstan, no? I'll show you this video. Look at it. Tell me, do you like it? Mukha bang totoo yung sinasabi ni Mr. Aguilar? No? Let's see it. Okay. Here we go. So that's the 20 megawatts facility in Kazakhstan. Now let's look at the 50 megawatts naman. No, this is different, the 50 megawatts. Okay. 50 megawatts, here we go. That's a 50 megawatts facility. So kung titingnan po ninyo, I don't know what you noticed, no? But if you will look at it, that's how the genius Eyal Abramovich was able to determine how a mining facility can really be very, very efficient. Because that is what we have and that is what we claim. We are one of the most efficient mining facility. So we do not have mining rigs, no? We have a whole facility. Imagine mo yung 20 megawatts. Pag sinabi mong 20 megawatts na mining facility, ang isang megawatts, okay, ay nakaka-supply ng kuryente sa 1,000 houses. So try to imagine how big, 50 megawatt, gaano kalaking kuryente ang kinakain nun. And lastly, I'd like to show you, okay, a video. This is the last video, another 1 minute video. Yung biyahe naman po namin sa Kazakhstan. This is the official video of Mining City. And, yeah, I'd like to show this to you. Just want to show you something, okay? Kasi madali rin magsabi na ako, ginawa ko to, ginawa ko yan, di ba? What I want to show you is, okay, when I did my due diligence, now this is what I want to show you, okay? I really did my due diligence in before I bringing this company to the Philippines. That's Eyal Abramovich. yung naka-white po na polo, tapos merong blue navy blue na coat. The one in black na mukhang Korean, yan po si Hanil Park. Yan ang 01 or the global leader of Mining City, the first holder of a mining plan. He is the first mayor and he will be the first governor of Mining City. The one na merong sombrero, ako po yan, that's me. And that was the time when we were in Hilton Hotel, okay, and we were talking about ano yung vision nila, ano yung gagawin nila sa Pilipinas and everything. So please, enjoy the video. Alright, ayan. Ayan, naririnig nyo na ako. So yes, you can record. And I hope you enjoyed the videos. I wanted to show you na totoo pong merong mining facilities. Kasi madali talaga magsalita eh, no? So I hope you saw the mining facilities. I hope you saw how big it is. No? Kung makikita po ninyo, pati they make sure na wala talaga siya malalaking mga katabi, no? Open siya, ang hangin, green ang, kasi yan ang agreement with Kazakhstan, kailangan green na pro-protektahan ang environment even as we are a technological company, no? And then if you saw the spaces of one transformer to another, lahat po yun very very specific si Eyal Abramovich. Eh, yung parang warehouse na nilagyan lang ng isang katutak na exhaust para lumamig, you know, you saw it, it's true and true, no? So okay, let me continue. Balik po tayo. So I hope I was able to establish already Mining City and Mine Best to you. Okay, that the company is legit, that the company exists, that the facilities exist. Later on, pag meron pa po tayong time mamaya, ipapakita ko sa inyo yung binuksan nilang office ng Mine Best naman, no, sa Europe. Para makikita po ninyo. And then, let's move on now. Kasi we will be talking about mining cryptocurrency. So, ang Mining City po, dalawang cryptocurrency lang ang minamine niya. So, I hope you're looking at the screen. Ang minamine niya na cryptocurrency is number one, BTC. So, we started mining BTC as early as January last year, January 7, 2019. Tapos, today, ang isa pong ang minamine niya po today is BTCB and BTC. Dalawa po 'yan na minamine niya today, no? So 'yan lang po, wala na po siyang ibang minamine na cryptocurrency. Just two. Okay, so the good thing is that's why you are here now is apparently what they have projected. Last year kasi ang pangalan ng BTCB ng Bitcoin Vault, ang pangalan ng Bitcoin Vault last year was Project X. So if I, you know, if people would come here and present to you something like Project X, you know, you would have second thoughts, no? Baka magdalawa tatlong isip ka pa na sa Project X na yan, no? But ako personally, I myself did hesitate for a while. Nag-hesitate po ako nung nalaman ko yung Project X. So what I did was I just watch it from the sidelines for a while, and eventually this year, wow, grabe na nangyari. So let's talk about Bitcoin Vault. Bitcoin Vault is the cryptocurrency that we are talking about today. What does Bitcoin Vault offers? Number one, Okay, let me share with you that Bitcoin Vault has been patterned and designed, okay, to the DNA of BTC or Bitcoin. So parehong-pareho po sila, the same 21 million ang supply, pareho sila ng Bitcoin Core 0.18, pareho sila ng kaya pareho sila ng algorithm, pareho sila ng machine na pwedeng gamitin pang mine, no? You can use the same machine na pang mine. Okay? So yan ang pagkakapareho ng Bitcoin Vault at ng Bitcoin. Okay, the difference now is Bitcoin Vault is better. Okay, hold on. Can you give me just 1 second, please? Hold on, please. Okay, so Bitcoin Vault is better. Bitcoin Vault is better in many sense kasi meron po siyang additional features. Number one is, like Bitcoin, Bitcoin Vault, ang kanyang pinaka-purpose is a store of value. Okay? So, meron siyang long-term store of value. Yan po ang Bitcoin Vault. Eto. No, I just wanna... There. And then, ang isa pa pong maganda kay Bitcoin Vault, protected siya from theft. So, when we say protected from theft, kasi last year, 2019, 4 billion worth, 4 billion US dollar worth of Bitcoin have been stolen last year. So right now, pre-protect po natin yan. In fact, yung sabi nga ni A.L. Abramovich, Bitcoin Vault is the answer to the different problems that we saw in the cryptocurrency industry. Kaya talagang binabanner ng Bitcoin Vault is a higher standard in security. And you can get your wallet, your first Bitcoin Vault wallet, no, in Windows, Mac OS, Linux, and Google Play. So available na po yan. Pwede nyo, ang pangalan ng wallet na yan, the first Bitcoin Vault wallet is Gold Wallet. Okay? Ano pa? Why choose Bitcoin Vault? Kasi Bitcoin Vault, number one, is secure. Number two, it's simple. What do you mean simple? It is based on Bitcoin Core with additional features. And number three, it is flexible, meaning users can decide between fast and ultra secure transfers. No? So, ito po ang mga features ni Bitcoin Vault. And lastly, okay, Bitcoin Vault is the first cryptocurrency blockchain na pumasok po sa decentralized digital mining standards. Okay? Okay. Sorry po, Mr. Gab. Linux is pronounced Linux. Okay, so Linux po siya. You can download it in Linux. Right? Sa Linux OS po siya available din. Okay? So, let's move on. Thank you for the correction. Now I can pronounce it properly. Okay. Let's move on. Okay, ito po yung gusto kong titignan ninyo because this is the opportunity that we have with Bitcoin Vault. Ano yan? If you will look at the roadmap of Bitcoin Vault, it has established everything that it wanted to accomplish and slowly, on the dot, it is accomplishing it. But the two things that I'd like you to look at Bitcoin Vault right now is number one, okay, this one. It is written in the, it is part of their white paper or their roadmap. Ito pong dalawang bagay na isi-share ko sa inyo. Number one, Bitcoin Vault will catch the volume of BTC in 1 year. That is the program that they have. So how will they do that? Gumawa sila ng period December 2019 to December 2020 where there is expedited mining. Expedited mining meaning there will be a substantially higher mining rewards for early miners. So dito po yan, if you will look at the pie here, the pie chart, 2019 ng December, ito po yung start niyan. Okay, the whole 50% ng 21 million ng Bitcoin Vault will be given away or will be distributed for mining in 1 year's time. So that's expedited and that's fast. Okay? Half of 21 million is 10.5 million Bitcoin Vault. And it will be distributed, okay, in 1 year. First, yung una, yung 11% are for early adopters. Yung 21% na next is for the first half of 2020. Okay? And then, The second half of 2020, the last 18% naman. Okay, kaya nga, ito po yung opportunity natin ngayon. We are already coming to the end of the first half of 2020, itong June. But still, we have about 700, kasi 6.7 po yan. 6.7 million. So, ang in circulation ngayon na Bitcoin Vault is 5.9 million Bitcoin Vault. So, meron pa tayong 700 million until the end of June na available for distribution. And then, pagpasok po ng July, yung 18% naman na yon. After that, after nitong expedited mining na ito, itong opportunity na ito, okay, the rest, after December 2020 will be for global adoption na siya. No? So that's 50%. Dito po, we have a bigger piece of the pie. After that, smaller piece of the pie na. Masarap pa rin siya, no? Beneficial pa rin siya kasi mataas na po ang presyo niyan definitely pagdating nitong global adoption. But the point is, are you willing to lose your opportunity today for that higher rewards? No? The second thing na gusto po kong tingnan ninyo na very, very clear sa roadmap ng Bitcoin Vault is that it will catch the price of Bitcoin by May 2024. So that is the objective of Bitcoin Vault. So what did they do? To be able to do that, mining rewards will decrease every 6 months. Ayan po, Bitcoin Vault. Mining rewards will decrease every 6 months to catch up to the amount of Bitcoin in 2024. Okay? Eh si Bitcoin po kasi, si Bitcoin, yung mining rewards decrease niya, yun yung tinatawag na halving. Di ba? Halving. So si Bitcoin po, nagkaroon ng halving every 4 years. Kaya kita ninyo, every halving, ine-expect, everybody expect tataas ang presyo niya. No? Si Bitcoin Vault naman po, every 6 months, para maabot niya yung presyo ni BTC. So that is what we are looking at right now. Right now, we have a very young cryptocurrency in the market today. Yun, that's another thing that is very beautiful. It is very young, but it is already in the market. Nasa market na po siya today. Okay? Tingnan po ninyo ito. Ang mining natin ng Bitcoin Gold, no? Ayan. Exahash ang gamit natin. Exahash. 5.2 exahash. Ano po ibig sabihin ng exahash? Ang exahash, ang ibig sabihin niyan, quintillion hashes. No? Quintillion hashes. So, right now, we are being mined, or Bitcoin Vault is being mined at 5.2 exahash. Coins in circulation, 5.9, like I was saying earlier. At ang, ito pong maganda, ang market capitalization ngayon ng Bitcoin Vault is $1.2 billion already. Okay, malayo pa yan kay BTC, kay Kuya. Kuya niya si BTC, di ba? Si Bitcoin. Kasi si Bitcoin po, $175 billion ang market capitalization niya ngayon. He was able to do that in 12 years, no? Kaya na-accomplish na po yan. Si Bitcoin Vault po ngayon, 1.2 billion siya. And he was able to accomplish that in 5 months. 5 months pa lang po tayo, ano? So that's our opportunity today. A very young cryptocurrency, 5 months in the market, but we are already in the market. Yun yung gusto kong i-emphasize. We are already in the market. What do you mean, sir? We are already in the market. Simple lang. Okay? We are already in the market, meaning there. We have already 4 major exchangers na kung nasaan nandyan si Bitcoin Vault. Okay? We are in Coinil. This is a very big Korean exchanger, no? We are in liquid.com, we are in MXC, and we are in Bakex. Yan po yung mga exchangers natin ngayon. So what's good about this? When your coin or your cryptocurrency are in the exchangers right now, this is what it means. Number one, you can buy. Number two, you can sell. Oh, so if you want, you can buy. If you have, you can sell. And it is being traded daily already. Araw-araw po yan, trinitrade ang Bitcoin Vault. So Bitcoin Vault is being traded daily. Kaya tuloy-tuloy siya nag-i-increase din ang price. But what you can do is you can research. You type Bitcoin Vault and you will see in Google, lalabas po yan. We are there in CoinMarketCap. We are in CoinPaprika. We are in CoinRanking. We are in CoinGecko. We are in Coinbase. I'm not afraid to say this, but if you open us in CoinMarketCap, okay, you will see that our ranking there is between 2060 to 2065. yun po yung ranking natin doon. Because at this point in time, okay, Bitcoin Vault has decided not to put in the coin market right now kung ano na yung kanyang coin market capitalization. So hindi naka-declare na 1.2 billion na ang market capitalization niya. So ganun ang ano natin. Ganun ang ranking natin ngayon sa coin market cap. But the moment that we bring our capitalization, market capitalization in the market, pagka inopen na natin yan sa kanila, makikita nila Bitcoin Vault right now after 5 months is in the top 20 cryptocurrency in the world. Okay, based on coin market capitalization. So, and growth, of course, syempre, and growth. So, yan po yung nasan tayo ngayon. That is where we are right now, no? We are being traded. Okay, lagyan ko lang konting ano to ha. Lagyan ko lang konting notes itong ano natin, slide natin. Tingnan niyo. Ito po diyan tayo ni launch nung December. Okay, $1 ang rate natin sa Coinil nung December. Ito po February na pumasok, February. That's why, no, during nung February, between February and March, we were being traded, no? We were being traded at $60,000 lang po. $60,000 US ang trading volume natin. Eventually pumasok po ang MXC, no? Diyan lumalakas na yung program natin nung naging tatlo na sila at naging apat na sila. Right now, we are being traded at 25, 'di ba dito $60,000. Right now, we are being traded at $25 million. Okay? On a daily basis. No, ibig sabihin 25 million po na worth ng US dollars, $25 million na Bitcoin Vault ang binibili at binebenta on a daily basis sa mga exchanges natin. So that is how Bitcoin Vault is growing to be very strong currency today. Okay, tingnan po ninyo. I'll show you the chart para hindi tayo nagsisimula na yun. I got this from CoinMarketCap. No? Kinuha ko po yan sa CoinMarketCap. Ito po siya. CoinMarketCap. Ang market capitalization, naka-zero pa lang yan. Sabi ko sa inyo, hindi siya declared, di ba? Pero tingnan ninyo, yung price niya, $25.63 nung March 27, 2020. That was just 2 months ago. Okay? At ang kanyang trading volume was $63,000. There you go. Okay. Ngayon, nandito na tayo. This was yesterday, di ba? Ang kanyang price na as of yesterday is $201.59. June 5. Okay? At ang kanyang trading volume 24 hours is $22,443,152. That's how strong our currency is today, Bitcoin Vault is today, no? So tanggalin natin yung mga presyo na yan para makita natin yung kanyang growth, yung kanyang chart. Ito po yung kanyang chart. So if you will see this, no? There you go. Yung kulay green po, yan po yung chart ni Bitcoin Vault. Okay, yan yung growth ni Bitcoin Vault. Sorry. That's the growth of Bitcoin Vault, the green one. And in US dollars po yan, yung green one. Yung yellow, yan naman po yung kanyang chart sa Bitcoin. Yan yung presyo niya sa Bitcoin. Okay? So kung makikita nyo po, nakikita nyo yung mga peaks and lows, di ba? Yung mga umaakyat. Nakikita ninyo, meron siyang similarity kay Bitcoin. Okay? Tumataas si Bitcoin, tataas din siya. Bababa si Bitcoin, medyo maapektuhan siya ng konti. Bakit nangyayari yon? Okay? Kasi po, ang trading pair ni Bitcoin Vault, okay, ang trading pair niya, so ganito po yung pagpupunta kayo sa exchange, BTCV. Ang trading pair niya, number one, ay BTC. At ang trading pair niya, BTCV, trading pair niya naman, USD, or sa ibang mga traders, or sa ibang exchanges, USDT ang tawag. Ibig sabihin, yan po yung trading pairs niya. Kaya pag medyo po tumaas ng konti, o medyo bumaba ng konti si BTC, medyo naapektuhan siya ng konti. But remember, that is the only reason kung bakit link yung dalawa. Because of the trading, mini-measure din po nila kung ano ang rate ni Bitcoin Vault sa Bitcoin. But other than that, if you will see this graph na kulay green, Bitcoin Vault has consistently established its own strength, its own rate, and its own growth. Tuloy-tuloy po siyang umaakyat. So, Ang maganda dyan, ganito yon. Ganito ang maganda dyan. Tuwing tataas si BTC, makikita mo yan, tataas din si Bitcoin Vault. Pag bababa si BTC, bababa ng konti si Bitcoin Vault. Pero mag-re-retrace lang siya ng konti, magpra-price correction lang siya. Tapos, balik na naman siya ang tumataas. But for the last 2 months po, Bitcoin Vault growth is 741% or 750%. Round off na natin. Okay? So, yan po si Bitcoin Vault. Okay. Let's move on. Let's see. Ayan. I will share with you. This is, ano, this is the website ng isa po nating, ano, exchanger, MXC. If you will see, when you open their site, you will see this already. That's their front page. They're claiming to be the world's leading assets trading platform. Okay? Ayan po. And then, if you will look at the exchange already, doon makikita mo, ayan, oh, BTCV and USDT. Ayan. BTC, BTCV, and BTC. Those are the trading pairs. Ibig sabihin, tuwing mag-trade kayo o mag-exchange kayo, dyan sa dalawang bagay na yan o dyan sa dalawang currency na yan, pwede nyo yung i-exchange si Bitcoin Vault. Ganon din sa dalawa pa nating exchangers. Okay? Itong kulay blue yan, si Liquid.com. Okay? Liquid.com. And if you will see again, BTCB, BTC. Actually, pag clinic mo nga yung BTC sa Liquid.com, makikita mo kagad number one sa list nila si BTCB. Pagka sa USD naman, syempre, ang nauuna si BTC. Pero, right next in line, si BTCB. Okay? Pagka dito naman sa Coinil, if you will look at it, sa trading pair na USDT, okay, makikita mo pang-apat po tayo, BTCB, USDT. Pero pag binuksan mo yung BTC na trading pair, makikita mo after Ethereum, Bitcoin Vault na second placer tayo. Okay? Sa listing. So, that's how strong we are right now. Ladies and gentlemen, ano pa ang hahanapin mo? Meron ka ng coin na mini-mina. Di ba? Pag nag-mina ka ng coin, ano ibig sabihin ng mining ng coin? When you mine a coin, like for example, our contract with ano, our contract with Mining City is for 1,100 days. Ano ibig sabihin nun? For 1,100 days, every day kang magmimina ng coin, every day kang makakatanggap ng coin sa wallet mo for 1,100 days. 'Yun ang ibig sabihin nun. So try to imagine this. This is the business that we have. When you engage a mining plan, every day for 1,100 days, makakatanggap ka ng Bitcoin Vault. Tapos, yung Bitcoin Vault na yan, pwede mong i-trade, pwede mong ibenta, pwede mong ibilin ulit, di ba? At pwede mong ipalit anytime sa kahit na anong exchanger natin. So, ano pa yung hahanapin mo? Tapos, tumataas pa yung growth niya. Di ba? Si Ethereum ngayon, naka-gain na naman ng ground. Bakit? Kasi, dati tumaas na yan. Tingnan nyo yung graph ni Ethereum. About a year and a half ago, ang taas-taas niya, bumagsak siya. Pero ngayon, konting-konti lang, tumataas na naman yung ground. Di ba? Ngayon, tumataas na naman yung rate niya. So, nakaka-gain na naman siya ng ground. Pero tayo, very, very organic yung growth natin. And we are here now. This is the big opportunity. Okay. Move on. Tingnan natin ngayon yung price. Dito naman ako natutuwa. Kasi ang Bitcoin Vault, umasok siya sa CoinMarketCap noong March 26. So, nabantayan ko na lang siya ng husto. Lalo na noong quarantine. Doon ko siya nabantayan ng husto. So, natignan ko araw-araw. April 15, ang rate ni Bitcoin Vault was $50. April 16, $52. April 17, $60. April 18, $62. April 19, $65. April 24, $67. Babalik ako dito ng konti sa April 15. Tingnan po ninyo yung difference yan. Kasi minsan, nadaanan lang mabilis eh. Hindi natin napapansin. But look at this. Okay? That's April 15, April 16, April 17. Ano po yan? That's 3 days. 3 days lang po yan. Imagine, if in that 3 days, you have one Bitcoin Vault. No? Ano tinamang itinaas na? Binili mo ng $50, after 3 days, $60 na siya. So, ibig sabihin, in 3 days, kumita ka ng $10. Paano kung meron kang 20? Di ba? 20 times 10. O, kumita ka ng $200. Saan kakikita ng $200 in 3 days? Na wala kang ginagawa, hawak mo lang. Hawak mo lang siya, kumita ka ng $200. You know, yan yung, those are the things na Napakagandang tingnan. Isa pa, meron tayong mga ini-engage na, di ba, sentimo lang ang itinatas, inaabangan na natin from 50 cents magiging 70 cents daw siya. Cents lang. Pero everyday, binabantayan mo. Ladies and gentlemen, dito po sa atin, Bitcoin Vault has showed us great potential. Bakit great potential? Kasi dito, hindi sentimo inaakyat natin. $50 in 1 month. Okay? April 29, 74. April 30, 85. Pagpasok ng Mayo, 96 na siya. Saan siya nagsimula? $50. Pagpasok ng after 15 days, 96. May 2. May 4, 107. Okay? May 6, 127. At nung May 8, $141 na siya. Okay, that's how strong our Bitcoin Vault is. I'll show you the money para ano, yung Bitcoin Vault wallet ko. No? So, nung April, I had 5 Bitcoin Vaults. So when I started, I had 5 Bitcoin Vaults. Meron akong $117. After a while, nagsimula po ako mag-mine, no? April 16. Again, I was mining already Bitcoin as early as last year. Pero nitong April 16 lang po ako, April 16 lang ako nagsimulang mag-mine ng Bitcoin Vault. Pumasok po, 7.6 na siya. But look at the jump of the rate. From 117, $524 na siya. Okay, after a few more days, yung 7.6 naging 9.3. Tignan niyo ulit yung jump ng rate. Magkano na siya? $800 na siya. Okay, so it was jumping a lot. Sabi ko sa inyo kanina, you can withdraw it, exchange it, di ba? And cash it anytime. So nung umabot ako ng 9.3, I encash already $300. Nag-encash ako ng $300. So pag encash ko po ng $300, siyempre bumaba yung Bitcoin Vault ko. Ito ang nangyari ngayon. Now let's see. Bumaba siya, naging 7.8 lang. Kanina 9.3, di ba? 9.3, $800. Bumaba siya. So malulungkot na ako kasi konti na ulit Bitcoin Vault ko. Pero ang rate ko, $1,000 na. Kanina, 800 yung 9. No? That's how strong it is. So, Bitcoin Vault, yung, alam mo, itong Bitcoin Vault, yung mining natin ng Bitcoin Vault, you can use whatever you're earning on your immediate expenses or immediate finances. You can do it for your midterm. You can do it for your long-term goals. That's Bitcoin Vault. Okay? So, ano pa? Paano ko sasali? Oh, yan na yung tanong. Sige, sir. So, it's good. You've established already. Bitcoin Vault is a strong cryptocurrency ngayon. So, I can mine now. But how do I mine? Answer. Ito po. This is how you mine. You will just choose a mining plan. You can choose as low as $300, $600, $1,200, $2,400, and $12,600. Yan po ang po pwede mong pagpilian. Sa $300 po, pare-pareho lang yan, no? Kahit anong plano ang gamitin mo, pare-pareho lang po, 1,100 days. Again, ulitin ko, 1,100 days, araw-araw kang makakatanggap ng Bitcoin Vault. Pare-pareho po yan. Ang pinagkaiba lang nila, yung hash rate na tinatawag. So, pagka 300 po, 3 tera hash. Pagka 600, 6 terahash. So, pag mas marami pong terahash ang nire-rent mo for 1,100 days, mas malaki din ang matatanggap mo na Bitcoin Vault every day. Katulad si $3 po, at $300 ang estimate po namin sa 0.015 daily ang matatanggap mo. Okay? Sa 600 naman po, 0.03. Sa 12, 1,200.06, so on and so forth. Makikita nyo po yan. Ano? So, pagka ginawa nyo po yan, ano naman ang po pwede kong ma-expect na pagbalik sa akin? Simple lang. Gawin po natin. Okay, thank you for the person who shared this to me. But I want to show you, what can you expect? Okay. What can you expect? Yan. Tingnan nyo na. Okay? So, you can see, this is what you can expect. Pagka ang kinuha mo, primary plan. No? Kukuha lang ako ng ibang kulay ng pen. Sandali. I'll use white. Okay. Pag ang kinuha mo ay primary plan, $300, ang makukuha mo po on a daily basis on the average is 0.015. Right now, ang rate po natin nasa 203 kanina when I checked. We'll check again later. But at 200 rate, you are receiving $3 a day. Kwentahin mo na po yan, $3 times 1,100 days. Yan po yung pwede mong kitain. Kailangan mo ng pera sa Pasko, so tinitignan mo kung magkano kikitain mo sa Pasko. Multiply mo po. Okay? Ano, paano natin i-multiply? 3, o dito na lang, $3 times 30 days. Ilan po yun? $90. Okay, $90 times 7 months. Okay, 7 times 9. Nahina ako sa math. 6 times 9. Anong 7 times 9? Pwede bang may kumulo? Okay. Ulitin natin. Pagka 9, 18, nasa math yun. 7 times 9. Okay, pag 4 times 9, tama ba? 36. Sandali nga, ika-calculator ko na lang. Pasensya na po kayo ha. Mahina ako sa math eh. Alam ko lang rate. 9 times 7 is 63. Okay, okay. Okay, so sa Pasko po, basically, pag hindi nagbago ang rate na natili sa $200, okay, meron kang $630 na bumalik sa'yo by Christmas time. Okay? Oh, mas maganda pagka $300, $400, or $500. And we are expecting, okay, at any time, between today and until the end of the year, that easily Bitcoin Gold will reach $500. Especially in the next 2 or 3 months, papasok na ang Bitcoin Gold sa Binance. Okay? So, you can expect na easily we will hit $500. So, parang kumikita ka ng $7.5 per day. Okay? So, yan po yung mga opportunities natin sa Bitcoin Gold. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the passive income. Ano ibig sabihin nun? Pag bumili ka ng mining plan, wala kang kailangan gawin. Hindi, wala ka na ibang gagawin kasi nga mining, you know? Uupo ka lang. So, this is what you do. Place, and then wait and see. Iintayin mo na lang. Araw-araw pumapasok, araw-araw pumapasok. That is what you do. So, this is the passive income. But we also have an active income. Ano naman yung active income natin? Yung active income natin, makukuha mo if you want to continue sharing the opportunity and Bitcoin Vault and Mining City to other people. So, ang active plan po natin, there are two ways to look at it, yung active plan po natin. Okay? There are 4 ways to earn and there are 2 trees. Meron pong dalawang puno, 2 trees. Number 1 is the team tree. Team tree is separate from the binary tree. Okay, team tree is can also be called as your referral tree. Okay? So susulat ko lang po dito. Referral tree. This is your referral tree. Referral tree. So ano nangyayari dito? Pagka sa referral tree po, okay? Ang bawat level mo, yung first level. Ang first level kasi natin, ang tawag dyan, direct referral natin. So, lahat ng direct referral natin, level 1 yan. Okay? O first level. Automatic po, lahat ng direct referral mo will fill in this referral tree. Meron kang team A at meron kang team B. Ano mangyayari doon? Yung first 5, member 1, member 2, member 3, member 4, member 5. The first 5, obligado po yan. System generated. Papasok po yan sa team A. Pag nabuo mo na yung first 5 mo, tapos na yung team A mo, lahat na nang iimbitahin mo from number 6 onwards will be team B. So magkano po ang referral bonus natin sa mga ito? Sa team A, very simple, $5. $5, 5%. Sorry, not $5, 5%. Sa team B po, 10%. Okay? Yan po ang pwede nating kitain. Okay, bibigyan ko po kayo ng example. I'll show you an example right now. Okay, kunyari po, this is you. So, you are the referrer. 5% ka dito, di ba? O, pagka naka 5% ka dito, okay, ito po, pumasok siya, 300. Okay. So, 5% yan, ano? $15. So, automatic po, meron kang $15 na direct referral sa'yo. That's it. Okay? Dito naman, di ba? 10 percenter ka dito. No? So dito po, pumasok ito naman, number 6 mo, $300 naman. Napuno mo na yan, ha? Napuno mo na siya. Kompleto ka na sa 1 to 5 mo. Yung number 6 mo, okay? Yung number 6 mo po, bumili ng $300 dahil 10% ka na, ang income mo naman dito is $30. So on and so forth. Pero lang po siya kasimple. Team 3. Tapos, pag nag-invite ka, tuloy-tuloy ka nag-invite ng direct mo, yan, tuloy-tuloy na po yan. Sila din, meron naman silang second level, di ba? Katulad to, example, si member 6 mo, yan, yung nasa team B mo po, yan, member number 6 mo. Okay, magbubuo siya ng grupo. Ganon din po yung mangyayari sa kanya. Automatic, yung una niyang iimbitahin na 5, nasa team A niya din. Tapos yung team B niya, sunod-sunod na po yan, lahat. No? Okay, ganon po yung structure ng team 3 natin. Huwag po kayong malilito kasi ito 17 naman po ang number na ano na nakalagay. Hindi po, kaya lang yan 17 kasi binibilang natin kung ilan yung total number ng nasa grupo mo. Kaya po ganyan yan. But that is your team 3. So natapos na po natin yung direct referral, di ba? Ulitin ko, direct referral is 5% para sa team A, 10% para sa team B. So that is direct referral. Puntahan naman natin yung indirect referral. Ano yung indirect referral? Dito po yun makikita. Indirect referral. Okay. Sa indirect referral, maggagaling lang po yan sa team B ninyo. From your team B. So kung ito po yung team B ninyo, di ba, yung number 6 mo, magbibuild din siya ng A niya. Okay? Dito sa A niya, kikita siya ng 5%. Tama? 5%. Sa A niya. So, si member 6, meron siyang 5% siya. Ikaw din po, no, bilang referrer ni member 6, sa team A niya, meron ka rin 5% sa buong team A niya na pupunta sa'yo as your indirect referrer. Okay? So, eto po, tuloy-tuloy po yan hanggang A, tuloy-tuloy yan, no? Let me, ganito po ang instruction yan. Sa direct referral mo, number 1, sa direct referral mo, A, 5%, B, okay, 10%. Number 2, yung indirect referral mo, yung B, di ba, ito po, B, at yung A niya, ito po, yung A niya, meron ka ulit, 5%. Yun yung indirect referral. Okay? So hanggang sa ang levels yan, okay, tuloy-tuloy po yan, magsisimula yan hanggang sa 10th level. Yung unang-unang ano, magkwa-qualify sa direct indirect referral na to hanggang 10th level. Di ba ito, first level, ikaw ang may direct. Pag in-invite niya, second level mo. Di ba? So dito, meron kang 5% ulit. Pagka nag-invite itong mga ito, yung A nila, third level mo na yun, meron ka ulit tigpa 5% doon. 5% ka na naman doon. Di ba? Hanggang sa 10th level, meron ka. No? So, those are the referral bonus na makukuha natin. The second tree sa Mining City is what we call the binary tree. So, the team tree is separate from the binary tree. So, ang sistema po dito sa Mining City, pagka marami kang na-invite, no? If you have invited a lot of people already, let's say you invited 10 people, yung 10 people po, nasa team 3 lang yan. Hindi pa yan pumapasok sa binary tree. Itong team 3 na po yan, para po yung holding tank. So, meron nandyan. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Di ba? Meron kang 10 na na-invite. So, anong mangyayari ngayon? Ang gagawin mo ngayon, pipili ka ngayon. Kahit na si number 10 ang last na pumasok sa'yo, pwede mo siyang ilagay dito kung wala ka pang nailalagay. Number 10. Si number 8, di ba, sa binary tree, pwede mo naman siyang ilagay sa number 8. Ganun po yun. No? So, this is the binary tree. Pipili ka ngayon, pwede mo ilagay dyan si 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, that is the process of doing the binary. You can 6, 7, di ba? Pwede po yan. Ganyan, pipili ka. So, maganda dyan, diba tayo po, mahilig tayo, nagpupwesto. Pupwesto kita, tapos lalagyan kita ng strong leg. So, minsan po, this comes to an advantage pag meron po tayong mga ganun na arrangement. O sige, di ba? Kahit pumasok na itong lahat, pero ang arrangement mo kasi, yung pang-8, just so happen na wala pa siyang pera nung kinausap mo siya, 1 week, gagawa niya ng paraan. So sige, pare, lahat ng team mo, ha, nakausap ko na ng direct ko, ilalagay ko sa ilalim mo. So, naka-waiting ka lang hanggang mailagay mo siya. Okay? Yun po yung mga advantages nito. Okay? So, that is how the system goes. Pero, paano yung kitaan? Ganun yung proseso, paano yung kitaan? Very, very simple lang po yan. Okay? Meron po tayong binary points sa bawat package natin. Yung 500 natin, meron po siyang 0.5 points. Yung, ay sorry, hindi 500. That's my mistake. Dati pala yun, lowest 500. 300 natin. Yung 300 natin, 0.5 siya. Yung 600 natin, 1 point. Yung 1-2, okay, 2 points. Yung 2-4, na package po natin, 4 points. Yung 4-2 na package, 7 points. Tapos yung 12-6 na package, okay, 21 points. Ayan po siya. So, ano ang mangyayari dyan ngayon? Yung binary match bonus natin o yung binary bonus natin, 5 points sa left, 5 points sa right, okay, magmamatch siya, meron ka ng $200 na kita para sa'yo. Yan po ang binary bonus mo. Basta po nagmatch siya. 5 points, 5 points. So example, gawin natin. Ito, kumuha ng 300. Ito, kumuha ng 600. Pareho silang 600. Okay, 600. Ito, kumuha ng 1-2. Ito, kumuha ng 2-4. Ito ulit, 1-2. Ito, 2-4. Ganyan yung ano, no? Okay, dito naman sa kabila, ito, kumuha ng 12,600. Tapos, isang 600, isang 2-4. So, ganyan pa lang, no? Ganyan pa lang ang tao mo. So, ano mangyayari ngayon dyan? Frequentahin ngayon ng system. Sasabihin ng system, okay, ilang points ba meron dito? So, ang possible na binary bonus mo dito, okay, lagyan muna natin ng points para makita natin, makompute natin ng mabuti. So, yung 3.5 yan, di ba? 0.5. Ito, 1 point, 1 point. Yung 1-2 is 2 points. Yung 2-4 is 4 points. 2 points, 4 points. So, ano po ang total niyan? 4, 4, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, 14.5 points. Meron ka dyan. 14.5. Dito naman, meron kang 21 points. Ha? Meron kang isang 4 points, meron kang isang 1 point. So, 25, 26 points ka dito. Ano po mangyayari dyan ngayon? This is what will happen now. Okay? Magkakaroon ka ng binary based on 5 points. So, ilang 5 points meron ka dyan? Dalawa. Ayaw nung pen. Okay. Okay. So, meron kang isang 5 points. Meron kang isang 5 points. Tama? Kasi matitira na lang 4.5. So, imamatch yan ngayon ng system for you. Pag nagmatch yan, meron kang 200 at meron kang $200. So, automatically, ang binary bonus mo ay $400 for these 2 matches. Tapos, matitirang points mo, nandun lang sa baba, mag-aabang na ulit. Meron kang 4.5 points dito at meron kang minus 5, 16 points dito. So, makikita mo, pag meron ulit pumasok na naman sa'yo na leader, alam mo na, okay? Remember, hiwalay ang team tree sa binary tree. So, pag may pumasok sa'yo ulit, alam mo kung saan mo ilalagay. Kung halimbawa, may pumasok sa'yo another 2-4. Di ba? So, saan mo siya ilalagay? Depende, depende kung gusto mo ilagay dito. Pero wisely, ilalagay mo muna naman siya dito para meron ka ulit 4 points, makapag-binary ka na naman ng 200. So, ganyan po yung binary system natin. So, let me clarify this. Again, for every 5 points on one side, you get $200 na bonus. Yan po yung binary natin. Ngayon, lastly, i-discuss ko sa inyo yung indirect binary. So, tatlong bagay na po ang na-discuss natin. Direct, referral, number 2, indirect, Di ba? Indirect referral. Number 3, direct binary. And number 4, very very simple, indirect binary. Ano yung ibig sabihin ng indirect binary? Ito na lang po, sasabihin ko sa inyo. Okay. Ang ibig sabihin ng indirect binary, lahat ng member sa ilalim mo, okay, basta galing sa direct mo, lahat po sila, pag nag-$200 sila na binary bonus, meron ka naman sa iyong $10. Okay? So, gagawin po natin, gagawa natin ng example yan. Ikaw ang referrer. That's you. Meron kang na-invite. Ang na-invite mo po ay si Jose. Si Jose, direct mo yan. At si Ogo ay direct mo. Jose tsaka si Ogo. So, sila po ay level 1 na sa'yo. Ang ibig sabihin lang ng indirect binary, dahil direct mo sila po, tuwing magkakaroon sila ng 5 points sa kanan, 5 points sa kaliwa, okay, magkakaroon sila ng $200. Di ba? Ang binary. So, tuwing magkakaroon po sila ng $200, meron ka namang $10 na income sa'yo. Ito rin si Jose, pag magkakaroon siya ng $200 na binary, okay, o pairing, okay, meron ka namang $10 na aakyat sa'yo as your bonus. Kaya siya indirect binary. Ito, maganda. Erasin natin yan. Okay? Ito po, maganda dyan. Ano? Ito, level 1 mo. Lagyan na lang natin level 1. Kasi ikaw nag-invite. Itong susunod na ito, level 2 mo yan. Level 2. Kasi ang nag-invite dyan, yung mga number 1 mo na. Diba? Level 2. Level 2. Tapos yung susunod, level 3. Diba? Okay. Level 3 na to. Level 3. Ito, number 2. Kasi in-invite pa ulit ng number 1 mo. Diba? Level 3. Level 3. Ito, level 3. Level 3. Kunyari yon number 2. Number 2. Okay. Ayan siya. No? Tapos, meron kang level 4. Diba? Depende po kasi yan sa ano eh. Sa kung anong pang ilan siya sa levels mo. Diba? Kunyari na lang, sabihin natin to lahat. 4 siya. Ayan. 3, 4, 4, 4. Kunyari. 4 levels. Levels yan. Yan po ang levels nyo, no? Okay. Kasi, meron po tayong doon sa indirect binary natin, meron yan by levels ulit. Tingnan natin kung ano yung mga levels na yan, ha? Okay? I just want to clarify po ng content. Ito po yan, no? Pagka-resident ka, okay, pag-resident ka, hindi po na mag-a-apply sa'yo yung, hindi mag-a-apply sa'yo yung binary, ay yung ano, yung indirect does not apply pag resident ka. Pero pag citizen ka na, up to 10 levels. Tandaan natin, 10. Pag builder ka, 15. Pag developer ka, 20. Pag city manager ka, 30 levels. Okay, so 10, 15, 20, 30. Tapos pag city chief manager ka, mayor, governor, infinity na yon, tuloy-tuloy na yon. So, ano ang gagawin natin? Balik tayo ngayon doon sa dinidiscuss ko kanina. Okay. Erasing ko lang po ito. 10, 15, 20, 30, tsaka 10, 15, 20, 30, tsaka infinity. Okay. Balik po tayo dyan. Okay? Di ba meron tayong indirect? Yung indirect po natin ay kikita ka ng $10 sa bawat magto 200 cycle. Okay? So, indirect natin, pagka merong nag 200 na member, $200 nag-income sa'yo, meron kang $10. Yun pong ibig sabihin, no? So, kung ikaw daw ay resident, okay, hanggang dito lang sa level 1. Pero kung ikaw ay citizen, ay, hindi pala, sorry. Pag resident ka, hindi applicable. Ama? Pag citizen ka, 10 levels. Tama ba yun? Okay. Mali yan. Mali yung binasa natin. Sorry, ako po yung nagkamali. Pagbigyan nyo na ako, patawarin nyo ako. Pag citizen ka pala, two levels po yun. My mistake. Two levels. So, two levels. Yeah. Pagka ikaw ay builder, okay. Four levels po yun. Okay. Pag developer ka, six levels. Pag manager ka, eight levels. Chief manager, 9. Pag mayor, 10. Pag governor, 11. Okay? So, yan po yung levels yan. So, ibig sabihin, sa yung, kaya tama pala ako nung una, yung resident, meron naman siyang 1. 1, ano, meron naman siyang 1 level. 1 level siya. Ganyan. So, pag resident ka, hanggang dito ka lang. Pero pag citizen ka hanggang dito, ano ibig sabihin nun? Pag citizen ka, ito, si Juan, pag nag-200 siya, di ba? Meron kang $10 sa'yo. Okay. Pero dahil citizen ka hanggang second level ka, ibig sabihin, itong si, yung second level na yan, pag nag-200 siya, may $10 ka na naman ulit sa'yo. Ganun din dito. Pag nag-200 dito, meron kang $10 na angat sa'yo. So, anong implication nun? Ito yung gusto ko makita ninyo. Tingnan natin kung ano yung implication nun. Pagka nakakuha ka sa binary tree mo, pag nakakuha ka, tracing ko po ah. Laruin ko lang na mabuti. Pag nakakuha ka sa binary mo ng isa sa kanan, isa sa kaliwa, pwede ka na bang kumita ng malaki? Yan ang tanong. Makakakita ka na ba ng malaki kung nakakuha ka lang ng dalawang direct sa binary? Yes, papaano yan, sir? Papaano kikita ng malaki pag nakakuha ka ng dalawa? Okay? Kailangan po yung level mo, let's say, umabot ka hanggang builder. Okay? So, four levels ka na, four levels. So, this is level 1, level 1. Level 2. Okay? Tingnan po ninyo, ha? Level 2. Direct ng direct ng direct ng direct. Ganyan yan, di ba? Okay. This is level 3. Hanggang level 3 na lang po tayo. Level 3. Hanggang level 3. Kikita ka dito. Tama? Paano ka kikita? Okay. Ang gagawin mo po, pagka ikaw nakakuha ka na ng dalawang direct mo, at sila meron ding tigda dalawang direct mo, ang mangyayari dyan ngayon, pwede ka nang hindi kumuha ng direct referral mo muna. Ang gagawin mo, bibuild mo lang itong team na ito para naman ito, mga tao na to, sa baba, ay mag-cycle. So, tulungan mo lang sila mag-cycle. So, para mag-cycle po sila, kailangan nilang 5 points dito, 5 points dyan. Magkakaroon ka ngayon ng 200. Ay, magkakaroon sila ng 200. Kita nila. Ikaw, kikita ka ng $10. Tama? O, galing, no? Ang gagawin mo lang objective, lahat po itong third level na ito, pakitain mo ng 200. Yan. Lahat sila, pag-cycle mo o pag-binary mo, match mo sila. 200. Ano mangyayari? Meron kang 1, 2, 3, 4. Meron ka pong apat na $10. So, meron kang $40 na kikitain sa'yo. Tama? Dito naman, sa dalawang ito, tingnan ninyo ha, meron kasi silang 10 points, 10 points. So, dalawang $200 po ang makukuha nito. Kasi meron din silang left and right eh. 5, 5, 5, 5. So, $200. O, meron ka na naman ulit, $20 nakikitain dito para sa'yo. Kasi yan, kumita yan. So dito rin, meron ka ulit $20. Another $40, nakita mo. Tapos ito, magmamatch na naman siya. Di ba? Magpipair na naman siya. Okay? Ilan ang pair niya? Apat. So meron ka na naman $40 na naman na nakaabang sa'yo dito. But apart from that, di ba? Apart from that, remember, meron itong tigpa 5 points. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40. Meron kang 40 points dito at meron kang 40 points dito kung ganun din ang ginawa mo para mag-match din yan para sa'yo. For every 5 points, $200 or $1,600 naman ang kinita mo dito para sa'yo. So, yun po yung implication ng binary tree in direct binary tsaka indirect binary. Okay? So, ladies and gentlemen, just to review, bibigyan ko lang po kayo ng quick review. Number one, ang ating pong income, meron tayong passive income, Ito yung basis natin dyan. You get a plan, and that is what you get every day based on the rate of Bitcoin Ball. Sa active income naman, meron tayong three, isang team three at isang binary three. Sa team three natin, review natin, team A, 5%, team B, 10%. Yung team A mo, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yung team B mo, number 6 onwards. Okay? Para naman sa indirect referral, okay? Sa team B mo, kung sino yung magbubuo ng team A, meron ka ding 5% doon. Up to the 10th level. Okay? So this is your first level, second level, third level. So kung titingnan natin paano ba yung leveling na yan, maintindihan natin yan dito. Ayan. First level, yung ni-refer mo. Second level, yung ni-refer nila. Third level, yung ni-refer naman nila. So saan ma-effect yung iyong ano, direct referral? Okay, yung direct referral mo, effective siya dito 5% sa team A, 10% sa team B, tapos indirect referral sa lahat ng B, A, A, meron kang 5%. Up to the 10th level. So, ang itsura niya ganito. B mo, A, 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 to the 10th level. No? To the 10th level. Meron kang 5%. Tapos, 5% yan, di ba? Meron kang 5%.